Hello everyone. Today we will be starting with a new module, that is agricultural pest. So in this, our discussion of today is marks of identification, life cycle, nature of damage and control measures of jawar stem borer. Jawar stem borer, marks of identification in adults. So how you will identify adults of jawar stem borer by looking at the external morphology. These insects are medium in size, yellowish brown in color and nocturnal. Males are smaller and darker than the females. Here you can see the diagrammatic representation of jawar stem borer. It measures 20 to 30 millimeter across the wing. Head has antenna, compound eyes. Fore wings are pale brown in color with dark brown to black spots towards the margin of the wings. The hind wing is different in male and female. It is straw colored in male and white in female. Abdomen is large. Now, life cycle of jawar stem borer. Adult lays eggs on the leaf of the jawar plant on the underside, that means on the ventral side, on either side of the midrib. Eggs are laid in 2 to 3 rows. Cluster of eggs are laid around 50 to 300 eggs. These eggs hatch after 6 days and larvae comes out. The larva has dark brown color head. After 3 to 4 weeks of growth and 5 molts, the 6th instar larvae undergoes pupation. Pupation occurs inside the tunnel of the stem where the larvae was feeding. After 7 to 10 days, adult emerges. Okay, so now let us study each stage in detail. So first stage is the egg stage. Female lays 200 to 300 eggs in 3 to 8 rows. Each row has a cluster of 50 to 150 eggs. Eggs are flat, oval, scale-like and laid on the ventral side of the leaves. Larvae hatch after 6 days. So here you can see in this diagram, ventral side of the leaf and beside the midrib, eggs are laid. The second stage is the larval stage. The newly hatched larvae migrates to the anterior part of the plant and makes tunnel in the midrib. They then bore into the stem just above the internode. The larvae are present in the growing heads. So here in the figure you can see a jawa plant and beside that diagrammatic sketch of the tunnel that has been made by the larvae in the stem, anterior part of the stem. Mature larvae is buff colored with brown head and has 4 longitudinal stripes on its body. It has mandibulate type of mouth parts and feeds voraciously on the pith that is present inside the stem. Fully developed larvae measures 25 millimeter in length. Development takes roughly 3 to 4 weeks with 5 molts. Then the 6th instar larvae develops into pupa. Third stage is the pupal stage. Larva pupates within the tunnel in the stem. The pupa is reddish brown in color. Tip of the abdomen bears 6 spines. Pupation takes 7 to 10 days. So here in this diagrammatic representation, you can see the tunnel in which the larvae was there. Later on, pupation occurs in the same tunnel. The fourth stage is the adult stage. Adult lives for a short time. It measures 20 to 30 millimeter across the wings. Males are smaller and darker than the females. The sole function of adult is to mate and lay eggs. नेचर ऑफ डैमेज, जवा स्टेम बोरर इज अ पेस्ट ऑफ जवा प्लांट एंड डिस्ट्रॉयज द लीव्स स्टेम एंड द प्लांट एज ए होल. द लार्वी फीड्स ऑन द लीव्स कॉजिंग होल ऑन द लीफ लैमिना. Caterpillars enter inside the stem and feed on the pith of the stem. Having mandibulate mouth parts, they are voracious feeder and destroy the plant very fast. This causes the anterior part of the plant to wilt, to dry, and that portion is called as dead heart. Farmers incur a loss of up to 80%. So here in this diagrammatic representation, you can see the dead heart. The anterior portion of the plant has wilted, dried up. Our next point is control measures of jawar stem borer. So first type of control is primary control measures. The dead shoots after the formation of dead heart has to be cut and removed, and the caterpillars along with the dead shoots, they are to be destroyed. After harvesting of the jawar, the stubbles that remain in the field are to be burned to kill the hibernating larvae. Hand picking or light trapping of adult moths can be done, and then after catching them, they can be killed. Growing resistant varieties of jawar plant helps in controlling this pest. Crop rotation is very important, because when we are doing crop rotation, there is a gap when the same crop will not be there and the pest will not get the host plant, and consequently it will die of starvation. So crop rotation is a good practice. The second control method is chemical control. Chemical control is very effective, but even then you cannot eradicate 100% of the pest. So some of the methods that we can use is dusting of DDT or endrin, spraying of parathion, but parathion is toxic to mammals and it is not recommended, but it is quite effective. Dieldrin, diazinon are also effective but need several weekly applications. Application of 4% granules of thiodone in leaf walls on 25th and 35th day of sowing helps in controlling the pest. Now we move on to the biological control. First one is egg parasite. So there are many different insects which are egg parasite of other insects. So one example that I have taken is Trichogramma. So Trichogramma is a egg parasite on the egg of jawar stem borer. So the Trichogramma female lays eggs on the egg of jawar stem borer, and the larvae or the grubs that come out from the Trichogramma egg feed on the egg of jawar stem borer and destroy the egg. Then second is the larval parasite. Brachychinensis is one example. Here the larvae of Brachychinensis feed on the larvae. So what happens is the female lays eggs on the larvae, okay, and then the eggs, from the eggs, the larvae that hatch out feed on the larvae of jawar stem borer and they control the larvae. Then there are certain larvae predators. For example, Coccinella septem punctata. So this is a predator of the larvae of jawar stem borer and feeds on them. Then fourth is microbes. So certain entomopathogenic nematodes are there, such as Neoplactena with bacteria, and they kill the larvae. Now let us see how they destroy the larvae. So here in the first stage, the infective juvenile stage of the nematode locates and infects an host or a larvae of jawar stem borer, and it releases bacteria into the host. In the next stage, what happens is death of host occurs and the nematodes develop and reproduce inside the nutrient-rich environment of the host caregiver. Then, as they go on developing, there is depletion of nutrient inside the body because they have used up the whole nutrients, and then again infective juveniles are formed, and these infective juveniles, they come out of the dead body or out of the warm body, and they wait again for new host, and that is how they kill the larvae. Okay, so the presence of bacteria inside these nematodes kills the larvae. Okay, so both nematode and bacteria act together and destroy the larvae. So we end up with our discussion of Jawar's stem borer. So thank you, everyone.